Now we will see the calculation part of cooling tower experiment. Here you can see this is the observation table given in the manual. And here we have temperature T1 to T8. Those temperatures we have found out by experiment. Then water flow LPM, that also we have taken the readings. And manometric difference in mm, that also we have taken. So here you can see I have provided temperature readings T1 to T8 for all the 5 observations. Then LPM of water has been written over here, and manometric difference in mm, that you can go through the video and you have to take the difference. Okay, higher height minus lower height, that difference you have to write it over here. Okay, so all the 5 differences you can write over here. Next, after the observation table, we have sample calculation for any of the readings. Okay, observation 1 or observation 2 or observation 3, observation 4, observation 5. Okay, you can do this batch wise also. So you have to show the calculations over here. And this is the result table. So same result table I have shown over here. We have 5 observations. Then we have to find out range, approach and tower efficiency. Now, what is the definition of tower range? It is hot water inlet temperature minus hot water outlet temperature. So T1 minus T2, it is range. Then approach, it is hot water outlet temperature, which is T2 minus wet bulb temperature of entering air, which is T4. So T2 minus T4 is approach. So we'll see the calculation part now. So we can do the calculations in Excel easily. Range is T1 minus T2. So equal to T1 minus T2. Then drag this. We will get all the calculations of range. Approach equal to T2 minus T4. Enter. So this is the value of approach. And tower efficiency, it is equal to range upon range plus approach into 100. So this is tower efficiency. So we have completed the calculation part. Now here if you observe this T4 reading which I have written over here, it is not the actual value which we got during the experiment. Why? Because if you recall the setup, that T4 temperature, it is measured on the bottom side of the cooling tower, and on the bottom side that sensor, it is exposed to hot water. So whatever readings we got from the sensor, okay, there was error in that reading. So we have used sling psychrometer, and using that sling psychrometer, we have read value of wet bulb temperature. Okay, and that wet bulb temperature has been written over here. Okay, so this is about range and approach and efficiency. Now, what will be the conclusion of this experiment? For observation 1, 2 and 3, we have maintained same flow rate of water, while flow rate of air, it is increasing. So what point of conclusion we can write down? For observation 1, 2 and 3, water flow rate is constant and we are increasing air flow rate. So it can be seen that range is increasing because as air flow rate is increased, heat transfer rate increases. Then if you consider observation 3, 4 and 5, here we are changing the water flow rate, but air flow rate, it is same. So what conclusion can be written? For observation 3, 4 and 5, water flow rate is increased and air flow rate is kept constant. Therefore, range is decreasing because time available for heat transfer between water and air is reduced. So this is about the conclusion of cooling tower experiment.